Look at the table.
It's really hot. And I think we have to do it by ourselves.
I don't think so.
You don't think so?
Yeah. This is just for, you know, like cutting the pieces and then moving here. All the rest will be done.
The first thing just arrived, and I think we ordered something with shrimp and noodles. I don't know what that red thing is, maybe ginger? It's good. Try it. We ordered three things because we thought it won't be enough, but I think we should have ordered two. No? I wonder what this year is. So good, right? So in Japan you often see like this kind of thing at your table and you just take it and go to the cashier and pay there. Abedon, I'm giving you a 10 out of 10. It was so delicious. You also liked it, right? Cherry blossoms here are at full bloom and it looks really amazing. They just had coffee, they didn't have any coffee with milk, cappuccino whatsoever. Where you should take a photo, I think. From here I decided to record a voiceover because it was very peaceful and quiet at the temple and I wanted to be respectful and didn't want to disturb others with my annoying comments. Katsuō-ji temple is a bit remote but really easily accessible from Osaka. You can just take the subway until Senrichu, that's the last station, and then take the bus from there. These cute little red dolls that are scattered all around the temple are traditional Japanese lucky charms, and they are called daruma. They have empty eyes when you buy them, so you can make a wish while painting one eye. And once the goal is achieved, you can paint the other eye and bring the doll back to the temple. The dolls are actually hollow and they have this weight inside at the bottom, so they will always return to an upright position when you tilt them a little bit. And that symbolizes success, recovery, and the ability to overcome everything. I hope that was interesting, and see you in the next video.